Hello and welcome to our Townsman VR Dev Commentary. I am Philipp Nagelsbach, the game designer of this game. Townsman VR is a medieval city building game, and I want to show you around a bit and show you a bit of a development history behind this game. Townsman VR is a lot about interaction. I can interact with everything in this world, and the most important interaction is movement. Movement in VR is always a bit of a difficult topic because there are so many approaches and it's not a solved problem at all. We had some different approaches, so I will show you the first. In the beginning, we just had this floating island without water. It was just a floating disk that I could rotate by using a button or, in this case, a thumbstick, just rotate it around. And now I can reach a different part of the island with my hands. If I want to do something over here, I just rotate and do something here, like pick up this. But it's not ideal. It doesn't feel that great or interactive. So we try to expand it a bit. You could first grab the border and then drag the border around. It felt a bit better, but the horizontal movement is a bit bad. You get a bit motion sick of it, and you still are not as free. You can't move as freely around as you want. And also, it makes the islands we can have really small, because everything has to be in reach of your hand. So let's turn back on the water and show you what we came up with. So now you just grab anywhere on the ground and you pull yourself through the world. And now I can reach every position, every single spot on this island. So we could have much bigger islands now because I can reach everything. I can also turn around if I take my second hand and I grab with both hands. And now I rotate around these two points. I can put one hand forward, the other one back, and I rotate around the center of these two points. I can also just scale up. I grab outside with my hands stretched out and pull them back together. Now I'm really big, and with one pull of my hand, I am almost at the other side of the island. And I also can make myself smaller or make the island bigger, as you see it. Just grab with your hands close together and pull them apart. And now I'm about the size of this guy. Hi. Oh, he doesn't like me. But there are also voice interactions. Voice interactions in the game. I can, talk to him. Huh? Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hey. So we had to tune the interactions down a bit because we watched some YouTubers play the game and the people would always stop when they talked. So this is a bit annoying because they are interrupted in their work, and the players thought, what's happening? Why don't they work anymore? So now they only occasionally react to what I'm saying. Hello. Okay. The scaling had some issues, so people sometimes would get stuck if they are far up in the air and get really small. If they then move, they don't see movement. Because they are so small, it's barely noticeable. So we added the scale slider, or the zoom display, or how we call it in game. You can activate it, and now you see how big you are compared to the world. So if the helmet is big, I'm also really big, and now I can easily move back to the island. The other issue we had with scaling was that all the things you had hold in your hand are also scaling with you. So if I pick up this cat, now I scale bigger, and I release the cat again, I have a really big cat, and I can repeat this. Now I have a monster cat. Whoa! Spare me! Okay, let's make you small again. No, it's a really small cat. So what we did, now if I pick someone up and I scale up, this one, I think I broke him with my demonstration. I have to fix him. Okay, now it's okay again. Let's try it with this. Okay, now it works. This one is now getting smaller. In fact, it stays the same size when I'm changing size. So if I'm now really big, the deer is still the same size. So we knew the control system is great, but we have to explain it to the people. And we don't want a tutorial with boring text boxes. We want a real person telling you what to do. And to do that, we just recorded the player movement, in this case, my movement and my speech. So let's try this by showing you the external camera. So this is an external camera that is on follow mode. It follows me and looks at me. We used this camera a lot for our marketing material, our trailer footage that we used in the official trailer. And it has a few different options. It can also produce a tracking shot by moving between two points, or be a fixed camera at one position. And yeah, so now if I'm going to record a tutorial voice line, I'm just pressing a button and doing something like this. Good day. I am Sir Clunkalot, your personal advisor. And then later, I can clean up the animation. We can re-record the voice lines professionally and put it in the game. And then it will sound something like this. I have to start the tutorial. So now the tutorial will start, and he will tell me what to do.
I am Sir Clunkalot, your personal advisor. I will show you everything you can do on this island. Let's start with movement. If you want to move, you have to grab with your middle finger. Grab anywhere to move back and forth, or up and down. Try it yourself.
So he now explained the basic movement to me, and if I didn't listen and want him to remind me again, I can just slap him.
Anyway, if you want to move, you have to grab with your middle finger.
Grab, and he will always try to be in my vision area. So if I look at over here, he's now here. And if I do what he asks, he will continue the tutorial.
Well done. But you can do even more if you grab with both hands. Move one hand forward and the other hand back to turn around.
Okay. I know how to play, so I will skip the tutorial for now and talk a bit more about the interaction options we have in the game. The basic design philosophy we have for this game is allow the player everything they want, so they can try, they can interact with everything, and we build our game mechanics around that. So usually in city building games, you just place your construction sites and the people will build them automatically. But in this game, what players try first is, can I take this guy and put him over here? So you can do that, and you can directly interact with your population. So that's one key feature. Also, you see, we have this ragdoll system because tossing the people around is so much fun. We had to implement a cool ragdoll system. In the beginning, the ragdoll system was a bit broken, as everything is in the beginning if you implement it. So we had like really funny interactions. The heads of people were bouncing off their bodies because they had some collisions between them, or they didn't fall down, they just hang in the air, hung in the air if I release them. Or the most funny was, I just put them in the air and when they fly up like helicopters, it looked really, really great. But of course, no, the rectal works fine, I just throw them around. Yeah, they fall down, they stand up again, doesn't matter. Also, my hands are physical objects, so I can pick them up like this. And yeah, push them around on my hand. And so this feels really, yeah, really cool. But the main interaction with my townsmen is I assign jobs. So if I need a woodcutter, I take this one and put him next to a tree. And then he starts cutting wood. And if I want like a mason, I can put him next to the quarry and he will now cut some stones out of his rock. And there are lots of different jobs you can find in this world. Like I can turn him into a hunter if I find like here a deer. Oh, okay, he did go for the rabbit. And now the people, they work automatically, but you can always interact. He will now put it on the campfire. Yeah. Putting all these chops in was a lot of fun. The first hunter we had actually had no bow and arrow. He just cut down the deer with the axe from the woodcutter. But yeah, all the stuff is fixed now. You have a really cool hunter. Also have a fisherman, so if I put him near this lake, he will start fishing. But the interaction doesn't stop there. I can also fish by myself. Can just pick up fish and put them somewhere here. I will try to get back into the lake, but yeah, I can prevent that. And now I have some dead fish here, and I can also put it on the campfire, or I can give it to the cat here. Go. Wow, needs a lot of fish. Let's get another one. Actually, the cat feeding is a feature that was requested by players that played the game and tried it, and it didn't work yet, so now we have it in there. I can also put it on this campfire and even rotate it here myself. Now I have a grilled fish. Can I put it back on the storage like this? Like I said, the voice is also important. I can also blow at things like this cloud. Or even the windmill to make the miller work faster. Now we just need a miller to work here. But the miller needs some crops, so we need also a farmer. And as you see, I have only two people, that's not enough. So we, of course, also support the basic city building mechanics, that's, building new houses. You can just open the build menu, select a category, like take this house and put it somewhere you like, maybe here, in the middle of a town. And now I can get my workers here. Okay, you want to work in the windmill. Help you. Yeah. Take the other one, put him onto the construction site, and now he will construct this building. I can also always see how many resources are required. Here it's one wooden lock, But we also need a stone, and yeah, I think we have some stones from the quarry action earlier. No, we have no stone. So yeah, let's work in the quarry, get a new stone. And finish the building. So this is how I get new townspeople. And now I can turn this one into a mason. And build up my town. What we are also currently working on is a save system. So at any time now I can save the game. Like go to save and yeah, let's take the second slot and let's see, there's one stone in here, I have a second stone here. If I now load the game, it should restore the previous state where it's only one stone here and the guy is still over here. And yeah, like I said, this is one stone here. And he hasn't even started working here. So this feature isn't fully implemented yet. There are some small issues that have to be fixed, but yeah, very soon we should have a full save game system in Townsman VR. And I will now fast forward the game a bit to show you combat. So you can watch in this outside camera again, and I will, yeah, just build up my town. So now I have full town, a fully functional town. The miller produces flour. The baker here takes it to bake bread. The blacksmith is forging swords. And here I have a barracks. And this guy just takes the bread and puts it in here. And also gets a sword, and then he can train a new soldier. He won't become a new soldier, it's a new new unit that's created here. So you don't lose all your workers if you want a bigger army. And also these guys, they can't change their jobs. So they couldn't change back to woodcutters again. Because maybe you want to fight here next to a tree, and it would be bad if he just turns into a woodcutter instead. So now I have my first soldier here. I think I will also get an archer next. Maybe if work here. If I get more wood. But the woodcutter is lazy. Let's work here. So do I have swords? Yeah, I have one sword. I have four brats. Pieces of bread. Yeah. And to control my soldiers that are running around everywhere, I can build a rally flag. Just here. And the rally flag is our way to yeah, make the people stay at their position. So you hold your position here. Can assign them to the flag. And I can also move the flag to a new position. And the guy will follow. Now I have a second one. Let's put him next to him. Here, also here. And yeah, let's start an enemy attack. So now there should be a ship coming from somewhere out here. And my people are already at the right position. Oh, I stopped you from working. Oh, I have a new archer here. And they are prepared for the attack. I also have built a catapult. And I can do everything I want with this catapult. I can put it like here. Can also load it with everything I want. Like, why not take this fish here, this grilled fish, put it on here. And the last thing I can do is I can use these clouds. I can always split them apart or make bigger clouds here. This is a rain cloud that can turn off fire. If I squeeze it, but I can also just get a bigger black thundercloud that can produce lightning. And this is also helpful in battle. So let's see if I can defend this attack. You can't directly interact with these people because that would be too powerful and too easy. So I have to rely on my soldiers to fight them. Oh, and this is a bit hard. So I will take the lightning. I hit some, but I also hit my own people. So let's get the catapult. Yeah, and now I have defeated the enemies, I think. Oh no, one is left. Let's just take one of the swords they dropped. Ah, okay. He's defeated. Thanks for watching. You can play this game right now. It's in early access for Oculus Rift and HTC Vive. If you have any feedback, send it to us. We are really happy to hear about all your feedback. Thanks for watching and goodbye.